The topic is large sample hypothesis test for the mean n is bigger or equal than 30 using the p-value method. So let's read the definition. Definition says a null hypothesis H sub 0 contains the equality such as less or equal, bigger or equal, or equal. And the alternate hypothesis HA is the complement of H0. It contains strict inequalities such as strictly less, strictly bigger, or not equal. And what's the logic? What's the relationship between H0 and A sub A? If H0 is not true, then A sub A is true. So let's do this example. A nutritionist claims that the mean tuna consumption by a person in the United States is 3.1 pounds per year. A random sample of 60 people in the United States shows that the mean tuna consumption by a person is 2.9 pounds per year with a standard deviation of 0.94 pounds. At alpha equal 0.01, can you reject the nutritionist's claim? All right, like always, step one, we start with writing the claim A sub 0 and A sub A. So what's the claim? Where's the claim? Right here. The nutritionist claimed that the mean tuna consumption by a person in the United States is 3.1. So the claim is the mean equal 3.1. So since it has equality, right there, then that has to be a null hypothesis. So this is null hypothesis. Now how do we find the alternate hypothesis? Alternate hypothesis will be the complement of a null hypothesis. So we're looking at number three. The complement of equality will be not equal. So mu is not equal to 3.1 will be the alternate hypothesis. What would be step two? Step two, we need to look at the sampling distribution of x bar given mu is equal 3.1. So first let's write what is n. N is equal what? A random sample of 60. So n is equal 60 in the United States showed that the mean tuna consumption is 2.9. So x bar is 2.9 with a standard deviation 0.94, so S is equal 0.94. Now we look at the sampling distribution of X bar, so we're thinking about all the samples of 60, of N equals 60. So what would it be sampling distribution? We know the sampling distribution will be the sample of the population, which is 3.1. We know that its standard deviation it's the standard deviation of population over square root of n. Since that's not given, we can use s over square root of n, the standard deviation of the sample, which is 0.94 over square root of 60. And that's supposed to be equal to 0.121. All right, now the logic is we need, assuming H0 is true, we need to see how likely that we would observe X bar equal 2.9. So since this is 3.1, so 2.9 will be right here. So we want to find this probability, but not only that, because it's not equal, we want to know mu not equal to 3.1 means we need to find how likely we will get x bar this small and x bar too large. So according to the empirical rule, we know once we find this p, it's going to be equal, let's call this p1, it's going to be equal to p2. But the p-value will be 2 times, in other words, 2 times p1, right? let me write it, 2 times P1. So this is P1, right? P1 will be probability of X bar is less or equal than 2.9, given mu is equal to 3.1. So how do we do that? Using the calculator, this is going to be negative 1,000, right? We go in from negative 1,000 or 10,000, whatever, small number, real small number, at least for standard deviation away from 2.9, to 2.9. And then use the mu will be 3.1, and the standard deviation will be 0.121. If you use a calculator, you're going to get 0.492. And then the p-value will be 2 times that, which is 0.98. Now, of course, looking at the definition, we're checking if it's less or equal than alpha. Of course, it's not. This is bigger or equal. Alpha is given right here, 0.08. Strictly bigger than 0.08. So therefore, we fail to reject. Looking here, we fail. To reject a sub 0. Now all we're going to do is the interpretation. So we fail to reject, first of all, the claim is the claim is in a sub 0. So claim is a sub 0. We fail to reject, so we're going to use this. So what do we say? There is not enough evidence. There is not enough evidence to reject the claim what is the claim saying that the mean tuna claim is right here that the mean tuna consumption in the United States is 3.1 pounds per year. So this is the method that we get two tails. So there's a one tail here, and so this is the two tail test, right? So far, the previous example, we did a right and then right test, and we did the left tail test, and this is going to be two tail test. So that's it for this example.